Chapter 9, Kiss Your Ugly Frogs, Goodbye. In talking about what holds you back from becoming everything you are capable of becoming, we must deal with feelings of guilt and unworthiness. These feelings can sabotage all your hopes and dreams for success and happiness if you don't learn how to get rid of them. Feelings of guilt are learned. Children are not born with feelings of guilt. Every guilty feeling that you have as an adult was taught to you by your parents, siblings, and others as you were growing up. And because feelings of guilt have been learned, they can be unlearned as well. Parents use usually guilt on their children because guilt was used on them by their parents and often by their grandparents. Back through the generations, it becomes such a normal part of interacting that people are often unaware that they were using guilt. Some churches practice negative religion. In these churches and schools of thought, such as socialism and communism, guilt is usually systematically and deliberately to undermine emotions, destroy personalities, and make people easily controllable by the person using the guilt. Manipulation and control. When guilt is practiced deliberately, it is used for two purposes, manipulation and control. Throughout the centuries, people, including parents, have found that if others can be made to feel guilty about something, their emotions can be easily controlled. If their emotions can be controlled, they can be manipulated into doing or not doing something. For this reason, guilt is an insidious and evil emotion used exclusively to destroy people on the inside and lower their resistance to the control of others on the outside. Children become susceptible to feelings of guilt as a result of destructive criticism and lack of love. In addition, when children are told that they are no good or stupid or a disappointment to their parents or not very competent, they soon begin to develop feelings of unworthiness. Better or worse? When children are continually criticized as they're growing up, they soon begin to criticize themselves. This self-criticism manifests as negative comparisons with others. All around them, they see people who are doing better than they are, whether it is in sports, academics, or social activities. Because they have feelings of inferiority, they conclude naturally that if someone is doing better than they are in some area, that person must be better than them as well. After negatively comparing themselves with others, guilt-ridden people conclude, if someone is doing better than I am, that person must be worth more than I am. If that person is worth more, then I must be worthless. For this reason, intense feelings of guilt almost inevitably lead to feelings of worthlessness. A person who feels worthless, diminished, and of little value becomes insecure, pessimistic, angry, and dissatisfied. Many among the prison population today, for example, have zero sense of responsibility or self-esteem. Many of them can clearly remember their fathers or mothers telling them repeatedly that they were no good and they would end up in jail. Feelings of victimhood. Feelings of guilt lead very quickly to people seeing themselves as victims of life, circumstances, fate, society, and other factors. This feeling is expressed in the words, I am not good enough. These individuals continually compare themselves to others and say, I am not smart enough, I am not talented enough, I am not competent enough, I am no good, I can't. Now do this. The emotion of guilt often leads to a feeling that you have to take care of someone else's needs or feelings before or instead of your own. You feel you need to seek permission or approval before making a decision. Anticipate a situation that you may be made to feel guilty about and set a boundary in advance. For example, in the past, Christina would cooperate with her husband, committed her to a social event or networking situation that was inconvenient for her. But she represented going just because he felt guilty about putting her own needs first. Now she sets clear boundaries in advance. Her husband must ask her when an engagement comes up and lets her decide if she will attend or not. In this way, they respect each other's space and guilt cannot influence Christina's behavior. Avoid victim language. Once people develop feelings of guilt, unworthiness and inferiority, they continue to reinforce those feelings by using victim language. Fully 95% of the way you think and feel about yourself is determined by the way that you talk to yourself, your inner dialogue throughout the day. The inner dialogue of guilt-ridden people who see themselves as victims is full of complaining about, criticizing and blaming others. In their work and personal relations, they say, "I will try," or "I will do my best," which is merely an excuse for failure in advance. Whenever people say these words, you know that they are going to fail and disappoint, and they know it too. As Yoda in Star Wars said, "Do or do not, there is no try." Criticizing and complaining are forms of victim language as well. When you criticize and complain, you position yourself as a victim of those whom you are criticizing and complaining about in the first place. People who feel like victims continually make excuses. They offer up justifications and explanations for not trying, not setting goals, not being punctual, not fulfilling their responsibilities, and not doing the job that they were hired to do. They always see themselves as victims. Nothing is ever their fault. Free yourself from guilt. Here are four steps that you can take to get rid of the feelings of guilt that may have been programmed into you from an early age. Step 1. From this moment on, never criticize yourself for anything. Never say anything about yourself that you do not sincerely want to be true. Remember, the most powerful words in your vocabulary are the words that you say to yourself and believe. Make sure that they are positive and upbeat. The very best words that you can say to yourself over and over are, "I like myself, I can do it, and I am responsible." It's not possible to repeat these affirmations and feel negative or guilty at the same time. Step 2. Refuse to criticize anyone else for anything. Eliminate destructive criticism from your vocabulary. Be the kind of person from whom never is heard a discouraging word. Make it a habit to continually seek out positive things in other people and comment on them. Whenever you say anything nice to other person for any reason, you raise that person's self-esteem. When you raise the self-esteem of another, your own self-esteem goes up in equal measure. Step 3. Refuse to use guilt on other people for any reason. Abolish the use of guilt from your vocabulary, from your family, and from your friendships. Never try to make people feel guilty for something that they have done or not done. The greatest gift you can give others is that of unconditional love and acceptance. This means that you never criticize them for anything that they do or don't do. You praise, approve, or at the very least remain silent. Step 4. Refuse to be manipulated by guilt coming from someone else. From this day forward, reject any attempt to make you feel guilty for any reason. If your mother or father or someone else tries to make you feel guilty, simply ask, "You're not trying to make me feel guilty, are you?" and remain silent. Most people won't admit to attempting to manipulate another person using guilt. They will probably say, "Of course not." But if you ask, "Are you trying to make me feel guilty?" and the other person responds, "Yes, I am," you simply say, "Well, it's not going to work." It is absolutely amazing what happens when you tell people who are accustomed to manipulating you by using guilt that it's not going to work anymore. They may be angry and confused at first, but as they realize that using guilt has no effect on your behavior, they will begin to change and interact with you in a more positive way. Try it and see. Your great goal in life must be the elimination of negative emotions of all kinds. The two most powerful positive emotion builders are the phrases, "I like myself" and "I am responsible." The more you like yourself, the more responsibility you will accept. The more responsibility you will accept, the more you will like yourself. Each feeds on and reinforces the other. Now, do this. Identify one person who manipulates you with guilt and resolve to stop this negative pattern the next time it occurs. You can do this by setting a boundary in advance. For example, if someone does not respect your time in a meeting and has a tendency of going over the allotted amount of time, give him a 15-minute warning. Tell him that you will have to leave or do something else in 15 minutes, then stick to your deadline. Once you have broken the guilt-throwing syndrome with one person, you will feel confident in practicing it with everyone else in your life. It is the human nature to test the boundaries of a situation or relationship and to push as far as you can. The best way to stay strong and protected from the ugly frogs of guilt-throwers is to be clear about your boundaries from the beginning. Decide what feels comfortable to you emotionally and physically in your interactions with others. When you have clear boundaries, people may test you, but they will eventually accept your limits. When your boundaries are unclear, people will often push the limits and try to get as much from you as they can. Clarity is thus essential. Now do this. If you can't directly confront someone who makes you feel guilty, try sitting in front of an empty chair. Imagine the person were sitting in that chair. Tell her how you feel and say that you won't allow her to make you feel guilty anymore. Tell her that she will now have to assume responsibility for her own life, feelings and experiences. You are going to take care of yourself and do what makes you happy. If it helps, put a picture of the person on the other chair. If the concept of talking to a chair feels uncomfortable to you, consider practicing this conversation with someone with whom you feel comfortable.